And it was Straight Smile Solutions, straightsmilesolutions.com. And today we're going to talk about my top six reasons why you might need to put brackets, hopefully not bands, brackets on second molars or sevens in braces cases. And you don't always need to do this. Now, remember the difference between an Invisalign or a ClearCorrect or a clear aligner brand is, of course, you have to cover those second molars, because if you don't cover them, whether you're moving them or not, what's going to happen is that they're going to be uncovered, which is going to keep a little few millimeters of micro space in between those teeth because they're not covered, which is going to cause them to super erupt. We'll put a step between your sixes and your sevens, and that is not good. So that's why they are included. In braces, we don't always include them, but this is something you need to explain to your patient, because there's going to be some patients where they're going to go on day one, and there's some patients who aren't going to get them at all, and there's some patients that are going to get them maybe half or two-thirds of the way through, and there's some patients that are borderline, and you need to loop them in and help you make the decision whether or not you need it. So here's my top six reasons why I would eventually put brackets on second molars when needed. Okay, number one would be a premolar extraction case. I hope you're not doing too many of those, but occasionally you need to do them. And your closing spaces, anytime you're closing spaces, unless you're doing total absolute anchorage from front to back, you know, with usually with an additional supplemental anchorage, be it TADS or an appliance or something, or elastics. Usually you're, and if you're using like sequential distalization of teeth or something like that, usually you're going to get a little micro gap between the sixes and the sevens in the process of closing space, and you're going to have to get brackets on those sevens in order to close the spaces fully. You don't want to leave a perio trap, especially in the molars. That's bad. So yeah, assume if you have a premolar extraction case, you're going to have to eventually get on the sevens towards the end of the level and align phase before the space closure stage. Number two would be uprighting molars. So if you want to upright your first molars, you're going to have to get on the second molars. So that's going to be more towards the beginning. Third is going to be coordinated arches. If you have arches and you're having trouble coordinating them, or having trouble, ooh, I didn't even mention leveling curve of spi on the lower. That's another great reason. I could have made a seven. That's another reason you can put it on there. Coordinating arches or leveling a curve of spi would be a great reason to do it. You know, maybe not from day one, but maybe half to two-thirds of the way through, or before you're getting into the finishing and the detailing and the space closure or the AP correction. We've got fixing dental cross bites. Yeah, if you've got a dental cross bite on a six or a five, it's going to be a lot easier if you get on the seven. And if it's a skeletal cross bite, well, unless it's a kid, you probably just want to leave it alone and not try to mess with it, because weird things are going to happen. But ultimately, it really depends on the bone, and each patient is different. But if so, yeah, you're going to have to get on the second molars for that. If you've got impactions of second molars, well, yeah, then you're going to have to put a bracket on it. Usually that means an exposure or an EOB. And cases with max anchorage, it's better, the more, like, it's like tug of war, right? The more, goodness, there's a bird outside going nuts. Sorry about that. If the more teeth you have on your side, you know, if you're, let's say you're doing max anchorage and you're doing the front six teeth, the three, the two, the one, the two, the three versus the back teeth, right? The more teeth you conclude in the unit, the stronger it is, right? And those are bigger teeth in the back. They have more roots. So if you can include your seven, your six, and your five together and undertie them and loop them together, you got some really strong anchors there. You don't need TADS. You got all these guys, you know, put in a TPA or a NANS for anchorage, loop all those teeth together really strong and pull those suckers in the front back. Max anchorage, not a problem. You guys are going way too nuts with TADS when they're not even needed. So it's not that hard. Just learn to do good biomechanics. So those are my top six reasons, or seven, that you might need a bracket second molars. Very rarely do you need to do it from step one or from day one. And, you know, occasionally you'll get one where, you know, there's a good bite on it. Maybe it's just a tiny bit rotated. Well, that's a gray area. I call that gray area because I like to go over that in about the 18 niti stage with the patient and the parent. If it's a kiddo, if it's an adult, just with the patient, and say, hey, look, we're doing really great here. Kind of at this pivotal turning point stage where we can, and I want you to have as much control and feedback in your case as I do. My goal is, oh, so many noises today. My goal ultimately is to give the patient as much control as possible on their outcome. So I'm going to let them know, hey, this tooth's a little bit rotated, nothing wrong with it. Bite is really good, really healthy, good occlusion. probably no one's going to see it by your dental hygienist. It's way in the back, you know, no one's going to see it. No one's even going to notice it's rotated. But my goal is to give you perfect if that's what you want. Now, we can leave it or we can straighten it. The problem with straightening is it's not the most comfortable situation. For a few months, you're going to have to really be on a soft food diet. It is going to cut your cheek. It's not going to be the funnest 2 or 3 months or 4 or 5. I just want to give you the choice. I'm not going to put it on here unless you ask me for it. I'm happy to give you perfect, but I also don't want you to be miserable. So you got to decide if this is something that you value or not, basically. I'm only going to do it if you want me to, you know, but so you don't want to make it seem like they're putting you out, but you also don't want to hear them complain. So especially if something is just for cosmetic reasons and no one's ever going to see it but the dental hygienist and the dentist. So, you know, obviously if it needs uprighting, yeah, different story. If you have a perio trap, yeah, different story. If you don't have occlusion on it, yeah, different story. Okay. These are all different stories, but if there's no health reasons for straightening something and no one's ever going to see it, it's totally up to the patient and the parent. So those are my reasons. Hopefully that will inspire you and you guys know how to address it next time. All right. Thanks. Sorry for all the disruptions.